fizeste tudo de bicicleta, Sarita.
Uhum. Loucura.
Todo em branquinho, todo.
E com as luzes tão giras. Marinho tem.
Está só um sol do olho,
não sou louco.
Estranha, eu não percebo o que é que é. Não percebo o que é que isto é também. Não estou. Tô... You know. Look at this one. What the? Look at the entrance. Wow, it actually is Arabic. Do you see that? Mm-hmm. For sure. Wow. Okay. Look at this entrance too. It's like a fairy tale or something. Just pick it up and move it. You can do it. Move. We're not parking here. Move, kitty. Come on. Wow. This is how some people would run you over. You really enjoy?
How fast he ran at full speed just to get out in front of the car and be like, pet me.
Pet me now. I need attention.
I love you.
You're a crazy kitty.
Chicken.
Boa!
Que isso é tão fácil!
Fácil! É carnívoro, gente!
Uhum.
Não me estou a lembrar! É grande! Gigante. Já vi, é grande, morde!
Gigante.
E é carnívoro! Mas eu não me estou a lembrar do animal! O que é que é?
Não é específico. Só tem uma grande pista.
Não é um animal.
Não.
Ninguém é um dinossauro.
Yeah!
Na tua pose natural.
As you saw yesterday, me and my dad's side of the family went out for dinner. We didn't really have a very Eastery dinner, even though it was Easter yesterday. But anyway, after dinner, I got this bag of clothes that I left at my grandma's a few weeks ago before we went to the Dominican Republic. And I left them to have them altered here. So I'm very happy to finally have these because I actually really wanted to take all of these to the Dominican Republic since it's very warm and summery there. But over here in Portugal right now, it's sort of warm-ish, sunny, but very cloudy at the same time. And actually, as I'm recording this, it's raining outside. So the weather is not really ideal for these clothes. So I really wish that I had them before going to the Dominican Republic. But I have them now and I'm very happy about how they turned out, and I just want to show you guys pretty quickly what the things are. So the first thing I'm gonna try on again for you guys, because I have tried this on before on camera, is this pair of Chanel shorts. When I first got them, they were, because they're vintage, they were way longer than this. They went almost down to my knees, and even though I am interested in vintage clothes and I think they're really cool, I just couldn't really picture myself wearing them the way they were, so I had them altered. So this is what the shorts look like on now. They're fairly short, but not too short, and thank gosh they've got pockets in them, which is really great. And yeah, they just fit really well, and I'm just really, really happy about how they look now. Also, you might recognize this dress maybe from my pre-loved Kilo haul, which at the time was really, really big on me, but I really like the design of it. I like the super puffy sleeves, which look really interesting. I like this sort of choker effect that it has. And this dress, I just had it a lot more fitted to me, and I still feel like it could be a little bit tighter, but it does look a lot better, and it doesn't look like I'm wearing someone else's clothes as much. I also had to have it shortened a little bit because I'm not like super short, but I'm kind of short. And finally, I'm at the last item that I had altered. I think I'm one of those people that really gives seamstresses quite a bit of work, because a lot of times, even if I really like something and if it's the smallest size possible, it usually doesn't really fit me, right? So, yeah. Anyway, this dress I also got from Pre-Loved Kilo. I really liked the dress when I first got it, and it actually, I didn't have to tighten it at all. I just had to have it shortened a little bit because, again, it was a bit too long for me by like this much. So it fits me perfectly now. I love the shape of it. I love the material. It feels really comfortable, and it's a little stretchy too, which is really nice, and I love it. I just wanted to show you guys what some of the items that I've had altered look like, and I did get one item of clothing altered in the UK just one time. I went to get this skirt fitted, and it was an elastic band skirt, so I took it to a professional seamstress like store, I guess, and I asked them to just make it fit me. And the guy that was working there, he actually measured my waist and said that it would take a week, which I thought was a little bit too much for something that seems quite simple to me. I mean, I don't know how busy he was, so that might be why it took a week, but that wasn't even the real issue with it. He measured my waist, as I said, and he wrote down the measurements, and then a week later, I went to pick up my skirts. I paid £30 to get something so simple done, and it turned out to still be too big for me. Shortly after that, I came to Portugal and I brought another skirt to basically have the exact same thing done, just replace the elastic with something a lot smaller. It took 2 days for a seamstress here to do it, and it actually fit me, and it cost €5. €5 for something I was very happy with versus £30 for something I was not at all satisfied with. It wasn't really a complicated choice to make, so I just started bringing clothes here to have them altered instead of trying to alter them in the UK. It is true, I've only tried that one store, but even just based on the price difference, I don't really think it's worth it for me to try a different store or a different place and ask them to have clothes altered there. After all this clothes changing and rambling, let's continue with the vlog.